All right, so we should be fine now. Gonna make it to the hotel.
I'm glad you didn't win that bet, Moggy Lou.
Sure, you're glad, but what witch would be happy at losing? And you pampered Velvet like crazy. It's your fault I lost.
Really? I don't remember doing anything.
Nope, wasn't us.
Staying out of it is just as bad. If you don't throw salt or sugar into an open wound, you're guilty of being too nice. I lost the bet because of you. You owe me.
In that case, let us get in on the action.
Oh?
I'll bet 10,000 gold that Velvet cracked.
Uh-huh.
I'll make that same bet. 10,000.
Uh-huh. Hey! Wait a minute! You both know that I'm the one who wants to bet that she cracks.
Then you should have spoken up first.
We can call the whole thing off if you want.
No, no. What kind of gambler would I be if I backed down now? I'm afraid I have to take that bet. I hereby bet 10,000 that Velvet doesn't crack. What's so funny?
For someone so stubborn, you can be surprisingly cute sometimes.
You're calling a witch cute? That's slander! You both owe me the money you bet as reparations!
Everything should be fine now.
So, should I think of you as my sister?
I'm a Moloch named Ceres. I've inherited Selica's memories, that's all.
And that doesn't make you the same person?
What exactly defines a person's identity? I may have her body and her memories, but...
You're right. If your soul has changed, you're not the same person anymore.
Even if I were Selica, I don't have the right to be called your sister. I followed Artorias' orders without question, sacrificing my own flesh and blood.
What about me? I devoured you. I have no right to condemn you for what you've done.
There's a difference, Velvet. I wanted you to do it. Even had I survived, I would have given myself to you before long. I wanted you to have my power, no matter the cost.
But why?
Right after the advent, Selica's memories returned to me. It was then I understood what exactly it was I had done. Arthur, kind and caring, transformed into the cruel Artorias he is now.
Why did your memories return?
I don't know. I've heard that very rarely Malakim can regain the memories of their previous lives. Or perhaps this is my punishment for the pain I brought to you all. The stronger I feel my love for Arthur, the less I can forgive Artorias. My hatred of him has grown so deep, I'm not Selica anymore. As Ceres, I can never bring back the Arthur that I loved. Neither do I have the power to defeat Artorias. But you can. You're a Therian. You fully absorbed my power. You can face the Shepherd.
I know. I will stop him.
Forgive me, Velvet. I've pushed everything onto you. My hatred, my determination. I wanted to apologize one last time, at the end.
I'm glad I had a chance to know you. I'm glad that once I could be Lafi's sister. And Selica and Arthur's sister as well. I was happy.
And aww.
Velvet.
Should you be up so soon?
Yeah, but...
Stay back. It's finally come to this. But of course it did. After all, I chose my revenge over a world of peace. I can't complain if people call me the Lord of Calamity.
Velvet, whether you're human, demon, or Lord of Calamity, it doesn't change that you have beautiful hair.
Luffy said the same thing to me a long time ago. He gave me this comb.
Getting to switch her earrings.
I can tell it aches.
Yes. But even still, no. Because of that, I've made up my mind. I'm going to settle things with Artorias and Enominat, once and for all. It must be done. For my sake, and for the sake of those I loved.
I will too. Even without my compass, I'll place my hand on the wheel and chart my own course.
I will defeat Artorias. But if I kill Enominat, Lafayette, and me and the other Therians, they'll all...
A compass.
I don't know, maybe I'll get another one? I don't know.
Aizen, why the hell didn't you say something?
Calm down. You were passed out at the time, okay?
I'm going. I've gotta stop him.
What's going on?
We got a message from the Von Eltia.
That's great. Is everyone okay?
Yeah. For now.
Huh?
While Benwick and the others were making their getaway, they got word that Ifrid was spotted in Endgan. They said they're on their way to Lynel Island to meet him.
That has to be...
Yes, a trap. No doubt set by that horned demon, who may even be Ifrid himself.
Ifrid is a demon? Are you serious?
I said may.
Let's head to Lynel Island. Whoever it is, it's a lead. Besides, we can't afford to lose the Von Eltia.
How will we get there? Zavid probably sailed off with the ship we came in on.
We'll steal one from the harbor. I may be a calamity, but I'm frugal.
Curse it all. If only I'd noticed sooner.
Yeah. If only we noticed a lot of things.
How about this one? The hull looks sturdy, and I don't see anyone aboard.
You're surprisingly into this.
Maybe you've got a criminal streak in you after all.
Let me go answer this door.
No, I...
What do you think,
people starting to work on nerve. Too many people come over here to not have house keys. Hold on a second. There you go. Thomas here. Alright, I'm back.
Aizen, everything alright?
We're almost at Lynel Island, all thanks to this ship. She's got a good compass.
Yeah.
If only my inner compass held as steady. From the first moment I laid eyes upon that demon, I think I knew it was Ifrid. But some part of me refused to accept it.
That's because you're Ifrid's friend, don't you think? After all, he taught you that the Reaper's curse was part of you, part of your creed.
We were lost at sea once. 20 straight days we floated together, close to death. And all he says is, you sure know how to liven up an adventure.
He sounds like an incredible person.
You did the same thing for Velvet, you know.
Only because you taught me how, Aizen. Your wheel is yours to hold, right?
That's right. That's what it is to live by one's...
Look, it's Lynel Island!
Not good. The Von Eltia's already there. We're too late.
Eleanor! What's going on? What happened? Ohorn's demon attacked us out of nowhere!
They're breathing. Barely.
Zavid rushed here to save us. Had he not come when he did, we'd all be dead.
This is all because I hesitated.
Where'd they go? Zavid lured the beast away, towards the interior.
Let's go!
We're on this island again. Great. There we go.
Is that demon really Ifrid?
Aizen would know better than anyone, so I'd take it as a fact.
But I thought when people have a strong will like you and Kurogane, they don't lose themselves upon becoming a demon. From how Aizen talks about him, I'd say his strength of will should be considerable.
Even if you don't lose yourself, a demon is a demon. When you change, you're no longer human. I don't remember how I felt as a human, but I bet the human me would have thought I'm a real monster.
But would the old part of Ifrid allow him to be so obedient to the Abbey?
No. He didn't seem to be following Melchior of his own free will. I imagine Melchior's illusory arts are at play.
Like what we saw at Lorengan in a ball? Is that enough to control a demon?
It would seem so. But more importantly, someone with a psyche resilient enough to impress Aizen should be extraordinarily hard to turn into a demon.
So Melchior must be using a particularly nasty illusion, eh?
Ifrid, Aizen, please be okay.
Zavid, you all right? Stop. I know these fists. This is Ifrid.
Yeah, I can tell from the scar on this face when I lose
you. You fight back. Ifrid, she pulled me back from the brink. I owe him. This time, it's my turn to bring him back.
A demon can never be human again.
So what? It's supposed to make me change my creed? What do you think, Ifrid?
Zavid!
Going after kids now? Benwick and your crew risked their lives by your side. Zavid's an idiot, but he stands by his beliefs. I won't let anyone trample their creeds. Even you! Everything, Ifrid. And now, it's time to pay it back!
Are you all right with this, Aizen?
I am.
Killing Flash! But I'm this close, I won't miss! Form Zero! Thunder!
Wait, here's the
Bullshit.
End of the road.
Fee!
Taking hostages now.
I'm sorry. Just forget about me.
right. You've grown. You're a man now. Family, friends, everything I ever tried to hold on to, all of it trickled away, fell from my grasp. But a certain idiot once told me, if you can't hold something in your hand, then make a fist and take it by force. This fist will take everything back. Just like you told me to!
I know this fist. It's you. Sorry. Caused him a lot of trouble, didn't I?
Don't worry about it. We're friends, right?
No, look, you burned away the good stuff.
Damon changed back into a human?
Forget it. It's too late.
I'm sorry. If I only knew how to use my power.
Stop crying. Didn't you say you were prepared for anything?
And you were searching for Ifrid for so long.
You're still as soft as you ever were. Boy, I'll let you in on little secrets. Your power comes from being part of Enominat. Which means if you can seal off his domain, you actually got a chance of putting up a good fight.
Seal off his domain?
The four elemental Empyreans sleeping in the earth pulses. If you can rouse them from their slumber. Hurry, while Artorias and Enominat are occupied, they're getting ready for some ceremony of suppression. It's now or never, kid.
Thank you, Ifrid.
I'm just sad I can't go with you. This sounds like a goddamn blast.
I won't apologize.
You shouldn't. I'm grateful. You always kept things from getting to home. If we ever meet again, let's raise some hell. Aizen.
Yeah, we will. See you, Ifrid. I owe you one, Zavid.
We had a chance to bring him back, but you went and killed him. Next time I see you, we'll settle the score. Between me and your creed.
See you around, Zavid.
So, we need to wake the four elemental Empyreans? But how do we do it? Dunno. Maybe you tickle their divine footsies with a feather until they...
You're back!
And you're looking better.
Somehow. But what happened to that demon?
We killed him. Benwick. He...
Let me tell him. The rest of you, find Grimoire and ask her about the four Empyreans.
Aizen.
Are you sure?
Do it. He gave us this chance. We can't waste it.
Okay.
Resurrect the elemental Empyreans. True. If we do that, we might be able to suppress Enominat's domain.
How about we just release all the damn dragons?
Rewrite the minds of the Malakim that Enominat has under his control. I'm sure some will no longer obey their exorcists.
Good. We'll take a big bite out of their forces.
More importantly, Enominat will lose the ability to enhance the resonance of his exorcists. Most exorcists will no longer even be able to perceive Malakim at all, just like before. Of course, anyone as innately gifted as me is another story.
Will I become unable to see Lafayette?
We won't know until we try.
Eleanor?
Then let's give it a shot. I'll accept whatever happens.
But these elemental Empyreans, they're gods, right? You sure it's okay to disturb their beauty sleep?
They control the four elements. Waking them is likely to upset the balance of the world quite a bit.
I'll take that as a no, then.
We don't even know how to revive them. At worst.
If it's anything like the opening, then we need to offer a sacrifice at the Earth Pulse on a Scarlet Night.
We have to kill someone?
The act of killing is not essential to the ceremony. All that's needed is a soul free of malevolence.
Hmm. If that's true, then doesn't Velvet already have a whole belly full of them?
The exorcists I devoured.
It's perfect! You're a Therian. You're capable of releasing the power you absorb. The souls of the high-ranking exorcists you ate should do nicely.
Use Oscar and Teresa's souls to resurrect the Empyreans?
It's worth a try, at least. When's the next Scarlet Night? 3 years after the Advent. In other words, soon.
Hmm. Do we have enough time? The four Empyreans are asleep in different places, right?
Correct. Four Earth Pulses for four Empyreans. But if you use a life pool, you may be able to awaken all four at the same time.
A life pool?
Earth Pulses normally flow horizontally, but in exceptionally rare cases, they can flow vertically. This causes energy to collect at the Earth Pulse's base, forming a life pool. Though sometimes the energy flows the other way, upward, into what's called a life spring.
Oh, so if we make use of one of these life pools, a single sacrifice could reach all four Empyreans.
Where are they?
There's a life pool in the northern reaches of Midgand. But I heard a large temple was built over it recently.
That's the Empyrean throne! We can't go there, it's Enominat's home base!
Ah, most unfortunate.
Couldn't we use a life spring? It all connects to the same place, right? We'll have to go against its flow, but...
We'll force the soul right down its throat.
Where's the nearest life spring?
Our best bet would be Mount Killerouse.
Aizen?
I'm fine. What's done is done.
Killerouse? That's the volcano on the northernmost tip of Northgand, but it's a hellscape of ice and lava!
Naturally. Killerouse is the most powerful life spring there is.
So, in short... We shove the souls of the exorcists into the molten core of that volcano.
That should awaken the four elemental Empyreans. Together, they will seal off Enominat's domain.
It's just a theory, but...
It's one I'll put my money on.
Me too.
Then we're off to Northgand. Mount Killerouse is north of Helavies.
It's a Helavies, but there's no V in that word. I'm just saying...
The ship's ready to sail. Where are you headed?
We don't have a problem. If you've got a grudge, we can settle it here and now.
Huh? Why would we have a grudge against you guys? The first mate fought like the first mate. The captain died like the captain, right?
I suppose.
The no-swabby here can blame you for what happened. We're Ifrid's pirates, and don't forget it. We're not so pathetic that we need pity from some Lord of Calamity.
All right. The ship's in your hands.
Aye, aye. You can count on us.
I see. Orichalcum or not, Stormquell snapped like a twig.
I'm afraid so. It was Innominaut who did it. But I think Shigure could have done the same.
So hardness alone isn't enough. Forgive me. I thought I had found clarity, but it was only foolish pride.
You should be proud. You are, without a doubt, the greatest swordsmith in the world. I'm looking forward to your next blade.
Even now, you would still place your trust in me?
Of course. Is there any other swordsmith who could craft a blade out of orichalcum? You're a master of your art, a visionary who spent centuries working to forge a blade of legend. I'm honored to know you.
I don't know what to say.
Unless, of course, you've given up on making a sword to surpass Stormhowl.
Does this look like the face of a man who's given up?
Does it look like you have a face at all?
Not in the least.
We're making good time.
The only problem is that ceremony that Artorias was going on about. We don't know how long it'll take.
Eifried said they called it the Ceremony of Suppression. Most likely, it's how Innominaut plans to release his power.
Most likely. He hasn't absorbed Lafayette in your despair, so Innominaut should still be incomplete. But if his powers fully awaken...
Humanity will be robbed of their free will!
I can hear them celebrating now.
The uglinesses of the human soul are suppressed! And the world is free of malevolence! Hurrah! Hurrah!
Robbing humanity of its will... They'll be like I once was.
Something's coming!
Gotta be honest, really hope I don't get copyrighted for this.
Please, guys, let's not fight!
This is a domain?
Innominaut's domain.
Her wills have been stolen.
It's not been fully sealed away yet.
Rokuro, give him a good smacking. Wake him up.
On it.
Aizen.
Got it. We'll put in at the nearest harbor. To Port Zexon!
Ah! I feel like some jerk played tug of war with my brain.
Dig up some spirit. They're trying to strip away your will.
Merchant, you're all right.
I do not deserve to be all right. I used people, stepped on them just to make a profit. I even aided wanted criminals so that I could expand my business. My soul is black with ugliness and can never be forgiven.
Stop!
The world needs to be purified of malevolence. I don't belong here. I have to die. I have to die. I have to die.
No, it's not right!
You woke yet?
You can die if you want. But saying you have to die is a good way to make my blood boil.
Those awakened to their own malevolence seek to end their lives. Welcome to Artorias' uncompromising world of reason.
First they steal humanity's rudder, and now they want to say who lives and who dies?
We should find out what's happening here, unless you'd rather not see.
You're right. I wouldn't. But I won't hide from the truth any longer.
Before anything else, we'll need to confirm just how far his power reaches. Let's head to Logris.
So this is the result of their ceremony of suppression.
Seems that way. They've brought their peace to mankind.
The capital is silent as death.
Innominat's power did all of this. A god among gods.
Isn't there anyone here who still has free thought? I hope so. There has to be. Mommy!
That was a child.
Don't show any feelings, dear.
If they spot you, they'll...
Prince Percival! Tabitha! You're still you!
In the capital?
No, they're molecules.
It's a problem!
She shoved it up her ass.
Tabitha, your mind's still your own?
Yes, somehow. But Prince Percival and that girl.
Looks like those Malakim took them away somewhere.
The prince was trying to help us get away. He said that the Abbey was gathering those who still had control of their own will at the villa.
We need to go after the prince and see just what's going on at the villa.
We don't know what sort of defenses they have at the front gate. Let's sneak in through the back.
Good plan. Back into the catacombs, then.
You got it.
Fountains are
not just the fountains. Come
on, I didn't mean to. Honestly, didn't mean to do that.
First, I took nectar to escape all my hardships. Then I drank to run from all my pain. Even if I resisted, endured the pain, nothing changed. But I won't run anymore. What the world needs now isn't dependence, but freedom.
Hey now, that's the kind of repentance that should only come the morning after a night of fun and too much drink.
And if you're afraid of losing yourself, drinking is a far better option than falling under Yinominot's control.
Alright,
It won't change.
So those weren't demons. They were Malakim.
Yes. They were probably ordered to hunt down any humans who still possess free will. Inominat isn't whole, and his oppressive powers are not yet absolute. So he must be using the Malakim to find anyone he missed and process them. Sounds like him.
Process?
Be it a prince or a little girl.
Right here.
Yeah.
That was weird enough. But nevertheless.
A channeling circle! He's eating their will directly!
With an entrance like this, it's almost like...
Like we're a bunch of heroes.
Hey, not fair! We're supposed to say like what?
Really, dude?
Yes, thank you. Well, I know I can still feel scared out of my wits, at least.
It's all right now. We'll help you find your mommy, and then
Mommy was executed. They killed her because she stole food to give to me. But that's okay. They had to. Mommy was acting against reason.
So this is the true face of their suppression.
Yes, this is the ideal world sought by Shepherd Artorias. As long as malevolence gave rise to demons, this was the only way. That's why the Kingdom of Midgan consented to his plan. But I will never consent.
Without sadness, but also without joy. A world without hate, but also without love.
You suppose the whole world's like this now?
No. Even this close to the Empyrean's throne,
Some here have held on to their free will. Still, we don't have much time.
Right. I can feel Inominat's domain spreading even now. It's incomplete, but it's quickly growing stronger.
Even we might be suppressed if this keeps up, and then it'll be reason o'clock all day long.
Prince, Griffin is doing well.
Good. That's good. I'm happy. Truly. Until now, I thought I was just a tool to serve my country. But when my feelings were being torn from me, I felt myself want something. No, I thought. I don't want this. I don't want to lose who I am. I understand the true horror of this ideal world now. I know it's selfish to put this burden on you, but I beg you, stop all this. Stop Shepherd Artorias.
You said something to me once. A bird that cannot fly is no bird at all. And now I say this to you. People stripped of their feelings can never truly be alive.
Yeah, that's how I used to be.
We're going to defeat Artorias. We're going to make this world one where we can be ourselves. We're doing it for us, not for you.
You've changed, haven't you?
You really have. You used to be a sword wielded by your own hatred. But now, you're in control. You're the one who swings the blade.
Even if I still don't know when to sheath it.
Don't worry. When danger comes, I'll be there to protect you.
My, I'm jealous. It must be nice to have a reliable young man like that by your side.
It certainly is. Our Fee's a gallant soul.
Aizen. About Captain Ifrid.
I dealt with him. But the Abbey, they stomped all over Ifrid's pride to achieve this suppression of theirs. With these hands, I will destroy them.
Then I'm going to be selfish too. And as just another flawed human being, I will offer a humble prayer that you succeed.
Well, I'm pumped. Who wants to go cut our way into this throne of theirs?
We can't just barge in, Sword for Brains. We gotta prepare.
We stick to the plan. Wake up the four Empyreans and take Inominat's domain away from him.
Artorias said the ceremony wouldn't be complete until the Scarlet Knight. Will they complete the ceremony first, or will we awaken the Empyreans? It's a gamble.
Well, moping won't get us anywhere. Let's head to Mount Killerous.
Right. It's time to suppress the suppression.
Eleanor, did the exorcists know about this when they agreed to help Artorias?
They couldn't have. The exorcists I know fought for a world where people could live their lives in happiness and peace.
But then how do you explain the fact that the exorcists seem to accept what's going on?
Maybe that was just what I wanted to believe.
It could be that Inominat's suppression is also affecting the exorcists.
You mean Inominat might have taken control of their will and made them his tools?
Completely believable. Exorcists are too hard-headed to be open to much persuasion.
If I stayed with the Abbey, I might have accepted this world too. Thank you, Lafayette. It's your strength that protects my heart from wavering.
You really think so?
Of course I do.
have a little more self-confidence.
Guess it's a good thing I captured you then.
That's true. I owe you my gratitude as well. Thank you.
Seriously?
Quite. To be able to express what's in my heart is a wonderful thing.
You still drive me mad, but I can't disagree there.
Oh great, another cutscene.
Oh, good. It seems you're both still here inside me then.
It is not as though we desired these circumstances. We're only here because you ate us.
I'll make no apologies.
You wish to sacrifice us to the four elemental Empyreans, is that it?
Yes. I won't apologize for that, either.
It matters not. Your sins are nothing a mere apology could ever absolve.
I know.
At least you're aware of how selfish you are. Good for you, then.
Remember this well, Lord of Calamity. No matter how many times I am reborn, I will act the same.
As will I.
At least you got your eye back.
And I as well.
Did you say something?
Just dreaming is all. But I know now how deep my sins run.
Velvet, there's something I've wanted to talk to you about. It's about the Therians, and about Lafayette.
Let me guess. The link between us and Enominat.
Yes. There's no way of knowing what will happen until we actually try, but...
You don't have to worry about me. I said it before. Best just to blame all the wickedness of the world on the Lord of Calamity.
Don't you try to shoulder all of this yourself! We exorcists are just as much at fault for letting things come to this. So let me ponder what to do about Kamoana and the rest. But you need to think about Lafayette. There, I've said my piece.
I don't know which of us is more stubborn. Still, I've got to face the truth. I've got to tell him.
Good. This place hasn't been suppressed yet.
We're unloading. Give me a hand, will ya? Hey, you listening?
Sorry. Something just feels weird. Like there's something tugging at my thoughts.
Yeah, I've been hearing a lot of that lately. But pull yourself together. Yeesh!
Yet being the operative term here.
We'd better get a move on.
Benwick. Don't leave Kamoana or Medissa's domain. Got it? The Therians are part of Innominaut. They should be able to resist suppression to some extent.
Aye, aye. You watch yourself too, First Mate.
Mount Killerous is at the northern edge of Northgand. Bit of a trek.
It'd be nice if we could resupply along the way.
There's a town, Mercio, near the foot of the volcano. It faces the sea, but the currents lately have been too strong to approach it by water. However, the land route should still be clear.
The whole continent has been getting colder of late, not just Northgand.
Colder? Could it have something to do with Innominaut? Or maybe it's because the elemental Empyreans are asleep.
Both sound possible. But think too hard about the cold, and it'll give you the shivers.
Yeah, but even so...
Whatever the case, our course remains the same. We'll head to Mercio and work from there.
Thank you. finish this now.
Not bad.
You too.
Show you the beauty of my firework.
I'll just go around and set. I'm doomed. How the hell am I supposed to get out of here? Went to the ice caps? Shouldn't be.
Is this Mercio?
3 days on watch with no sleep? I was 10 freaking minutes late! It's not like the mine is gonna fall apart!
Hey,
Sure, whatever!
Yeah.
I didn't know so many people lived up here on the northern edge of the world.
This town was built around the mining of Flamestone, which can only be found here on Mount Killerous.
So if anything happens to the volcano, this town's screwed.
So releasing the two souls here will surely destroy the town. Inhuman, aren't I? Curse me all you want.
I have no right to. The Abbey has proven itself just as heartless.
People living here must have the will to endure the cold. To fight back against this pitiless environment. I'd rather have that strength than feel nothing in the face of my troubles and pain.
Agreed. A life without feeling is a box of stupid.
Yes, a vast container of... stupid.
Right. The question is, can we wake up all four elemental Imperium? If Inominat's revival and the Imperian slumber are...
I think... I'll only be able to wake two. There are only two souls left inside of me. Teresa's and Oscar's.
Are you sure?
Yes. I can tell.
I don't know if two Empyreans will be enough to fight him. This is my responsibility. I offer my own soul.
If we don't have enough, let's knock on Shigure's door. His soul would make a fine sacrifice.
Old man Melchior, too. His heart's as cold as a witch's teat, but he's free of malevolence.
You're truly ready to take on two Legates at once?
I was born ready. It's not like they'll sit back and ignore us anyway.
And with Artorias and Enomi not all tied up with their suppression party, this is the perfect chance to take them out.
Acting with caution is...
all right.
Damn.
So, I'm all stoked for the god waking, but what's the plan?
The road to the volcano is on the other side of town. Let's start by...
What a peaceful, serene...
You sure it isn't just the snow?
But doesn't it look pure and be... Well...
This is useless dialogue. This has nothing to do with the... This... Like, why do we stop it? Like, why do they do that? I understand they want to add to the dialogue, but damn. Can you make it relevant to the fact that we gotta go save the world and shit? That we're on a ticking clock? We can't... You know, like, damn, dude. Him or was it him?
Thank you.
What else we got to say? Thank you. It'll be good.
Me?
Got it. It's my turn.
If I'm in this, I'm in this 100%.
Oh, miss me that much, did ya?
Nobody has their arts off.
You're going to help me. I have a message for the Abbey's legates. On the next Scarlet Night, I will offer a sacrifice to Mount Killerous and strip Enominat of his power. I dare them to try and stop me!
She just ate the demon with her arm! She's...
I am corruption made flesh! Velvet! The Lord of Calamity! This city is ours! Flee to the south, puny humans, while your tears dug the snow!
The demon lord of Chaos!
Hurry, before our dark mistress sucks the marrow from your very bones!
She'll eat us all! Run for it!
That was splendid! We should do this more often!
It went well, except...
Ow! What was that for?
There will be no sucking of marrow. My sister taught me proper table manners.
Oh, what a waste. The marrow's the tastiest part.
It kinda is.
At least now the citizens of Mercio won't be swept up in our fight.
They already are. We just tore their homes and livelihoods away. This wasn't for them. This was to summon the legates here. That's all.
Even so, I thank you for what you've done, oh fearsome.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that, oh.
A whole crowd of people were fleeing south. What happened?
Benwick,
Why are you here?
I had a delivery for the first mate. Kurogane and Kamoana are here too.
You brought Kamoana?
She absolutely insisted on following me. Poor kid said she had a dream that you died, Eleanor.
Kamoana.
How long do we have until Shigure and the others get here?
Given the distance, my guess is they won't show up until the Scarlet Night.
Then I think I'll make use of that time. Kurogane wanted me for something, I take it?
All right, then. Everyone go rest up.
Good idea.
This may be the last break
we get. Anything could happen. Don't leave town.
Can I stay?
I don't mind, but...
Yeah.
Do what you like, then.
I'm just realizing I forgot to buy more recovery items.
Writing another letter to your sister?
Nope. This time she sent one to him. Man, she hardly ever writes back. Hope this ain't a bad omen.
Shut it.
Aizen, that's...
I told her about all of you in my last letter. Seems she was amused. Says you sound appropriate for me, and she'd love to meet you.
Weird sister you've got.
You don't know the half of it. A girl weird enough to want to live alongside the Reaper, no matter the cost.
I'd love to meet her, too.
I'll warn you.
Touch my sister and I'll kill you. Right? Sheesh, you say that to every guy you meet.
Awfully protective.
Nah, just obsessed.
We'll all go meet her together someday.
I like your confidence.
Yeah. I man the wheel of my own ship.
Aye, as do I. And even her.
Just for time in town, but
having fun?
Kamoana insisted that we play, so...
Madam Eleanor! I followed Kamoana for you! She's hiding right over there.
Wow, cheating against a kid? That's low.
I didn't! Bad Bianfu, no cheating!
Huh? But when I play with Miss Monkey Lu, she always makes me do that!
She's a terrible influence on you.
Eleanor, why aren't you looking for me?
I found you, Kamalana! And Dial!
What?
No fair!
See? That's cheating!
I didn't cheat. I simply utilized Bianfu's cheating. That's called strategy.
Plans must be solid and reactions flexible, right?
Right. See, Kamalana? I'm smart and strong. You don't have to worry about me.
Don't worry. I believe in you, Eleanor. I'm just worried that Bianfu will get you in trouble.
Why am I the bad guy now?
I can handle Bianfu, too. Don't worry. I'll make sure everyone makes it back safe.
Okay, it's a promise.
Kamoana, if you're feeling better now, head back, okay? It's too cold, you'll go into hibernation.
No sleeping! Dial's it next, because he's a crocodile!
I'm not a crocodile, I'm a lizard.
Isn't that the same thing?
Not even close! You think crocodiles can regrow their tails?
It has to be possible. There must be a way to make a better world for everyone. Human? It might take years. No, decades, centuries, generations. Even if it takes me millennia, I'll do it.
Playing the long game, I take it?
I believe in you, Eleanor.
I will. Once I've made up my mind, nothing can stop me.
Yep.
Trust me, we know.
Ah, here we go.
What's that sound?
It's Kurogane.
He must be forging another sword.
He certainly is. The old fellow's forging himself into a blade.
He's turning himself into a sword?
He can do that? Is that possible?
Who knows? Either way, it's what he decided to do. We had one last drink together.
I'm curious to know as to how we drink.
You'd go that far to defeat Shigure and Stormhowl.
I would. I'll turn a friend into a sword to kill my own brother. I'm a jerk.
I'm in no position to judge.
I think you are. Whatever you may look like, you're human. You hate because you love, and feel as much hurt as you do anger. That's human. Kurogane is with me. He agreed to it. What our blacksmith friend feels towards Stormhowl is more than resentment. It's admiration, too.
That's why he wanted to do it. He wanted to put everything he had into one final clash.
Shigure's the same. He has that very human strength to take the good along with the bad and just keep pushing ahead. A strength that I, as a demon, can never match.
Brooding doesn't suit you, Rokuro. You wanted to be a swordsman greater than any other. That's why you fought and bled to perfect your skills. That's the sort of man you are.
Yep. That's who I am.
I like that part of you, Rokuro.
Me too. Thanks.
Lord of Calamity, your schemes are your own business. But I won't stand by if Kamawana's fate is involved.
It's a bit late for that. If you mean to stop me, you'll have to strike me down first.
You asked for it.
Achoo!
I found an inn with a nice big hot spring. Warm yourself up before you catch cold.
What a darling you are! I'll take you up on that. Gotta conserve my strength.
Good idea. Fee, want to join me?
What? No way!
No need to hold back on my account. The bath at the inn should be huge.
Achoo!
See?
Why do you do this to me? I'll bathe alone, thank you. You go first.
Fine.
What is it?
Just a little errand. Watch these folks for a bit, all right?
Looks like you got our message.
You plan on awakening the four Empyreans?
Age hasn't dulled your wits, I see.
Surely you know the consequences. You know the chaos you will bring if you take that route.
Oh yeah, so much chaos. Enominat's amplified resonance will return to normal, the Malakim will regain free will. Many exorcists will lose their power to do whatever they do, and the Abbey will lose its means of control.
While the demon threat will remain unchanged.
Not only that, but the elemental balance of this world will be thrown into turmoil for hundreds of years. Earth will shift. Skies will go mad. Seas will swell. Volcanoes will erupt. It'll be quite a show.
All of civilization will regress. The eruption of Mount Killaros alone will rob humanity of its source of flamestone, and consequently, of gunpowder.
Sounds fun. Hey, don't worry about it. I'm sure mankind will think of something. Go humans! Right?
Just what do you think humans are?
The wellspring of all malevolence. Thus must emotion be quelled, and reason bring order to the world, until the day that humanity can repent and overcome their sins. I get that right?
You did. Enominat was awakened for that very purpose.
We are the instruments of change, hated for our sacrifice. We are the shadow of the shepherd who brings salvation.
Will you not return to our side? You still seem to think of yourself as a maven.
I can think of nothing more boring than your ideal world.
It is a world of purity.
A garden of fake flowers, good for show and nothing else.
It's a world of order built on righteous ideals.
Those ideals are twisted! Can a flower hold beauty if it does not wilt? Can a wolf be satisfied eating grass? The thought makes me wretch, as do those who wish for it, and those content to live in shackles! Let the biting bugs go ahead and eat what they want to eat. Let the weeds grow where they want to grow! Some may look down on them and scoff at their foolishness, but their unwavering wills are proof that they're alive! If that's what you call evil, then I will live and die with evil as my mantra!
Then I have no choice but to crush you.
Used to treating people as bugs, aren't you?
We got your back, Magilu.
Wait. Now is not the time. His life belongs to the Lord of Calamity. Melchior Maven, I'll see you at the volcano. Don't you worry. I'll be sure to be there as you breathe your last.
Very well. It will save me the trouble of having to crush you one by one.
You haven't changed at all, Master.
Well, that happened.
Oh, what a nice bath. How was the men's side?
Not bad. I feel warmer now.
Your face is all red. In there too long?
No, I feel fine. Oh.
You mind? Help me comb my hair.
Can I?
Yes, please.
Oh.
Be careful, okay? I can't contain it.
You know something, Velvet? Your hair is really beautiful. You know, that power that I have. If I could master the silver flame, I might
be able to turn you back into a human.
A human, huh? If we ever had a chance to start over, I'd love to cook for you every day. My quiches are much better than anything they sell in the stores.
Okay, then I'll fetch the water and chop the firewood.
All by yourself?
Of course! I'm gonna get a lot taller soon, and I'm gonna get stronger, too.
Yes, you will. I know you will.
Great! Then I'll start looking for a way to master...
No. It's too late. I've made too many sacrifices. Too many to ever come back from. I can't.
But Velvet...
Even worse, I haven't stopped. I'm willing to sacrifice others to keep going forward. If we kill Enominat, what will happen to the Therians who are part of him? Will they return to normal?
Well...
It's likely that they'll all die. I know it. I dug my own grave. But what about Kamoana and Medissa? More importantly, what about Yuffie? You are connected to him. I know I might die if I go through with this, but still I have to do it. Even if it means I have to sacrifice everyone that I know, even you who saved me. The Lord of Calamity isn't a demon lord. She's just a selfish, horrible girl.
I have something to confess. I don't like being called Fee. I really don't. I think that name's too childish.
Wafi said the same thing to me.
I'm sure that he did. Velvet, you really don't understand boys at all.
Yeah, you're right, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I forgive you.
Thank you. Off you said.
Is Velvet in there?
Yeah, but now's not the best time.
I'm here.
Dry up. Break time's over. The Legates have arrived.
No final battle speech.
Another Scarlet Knight.
Losing your nerve, Velvet?
I think not.
Don't worry. Leave Shigure to me.
Where's Kurogane?
Here with me. Kurogane and I will cut Shigure down.
And Aizen. Sorry, but Melchior is mine to eat. Got it?
Got it. But at the very least, you're gonna let me watch.
Mogulo, you do whatever you want. Go nuts out there. Benwick, when you see your chance, take the others back to the Von Eltia and await orders. Luffy said.
Let's go.
Eleanor, keep Lafayette safe, please.
I will. Worry not.
Let's move. We go to kill the Exorcist Legates and engulf this world in the flames of chaos!
Have a good trip! See you soon, Kay!
If only I could just use my power to seal Enominat.
Looks like you're raring to go, eh, Lafayette? Just don't be too eager to help, okay? You've got a bad habit of trying to play the good guy.
Oh no, I'm not a good guy. I'm a selfish, wicked little boy.
Oh, is that so?
But if you acknowledge your own selfishness, then it's something you've chosen for yourself, right?
Yeah.
Then we have that in common. Now, all that's left is to follow your own creed. Only that.
Besides, I'm a demon. Even if you were the worst of the worst, I'd be like, cool.
Thanks, Aizen. Thanks, Rokuro.
Velvet, don't give up on Lafayette just yet, okay?
So, you were eavesdropping on us at the inn.
Heavens! I never knew a praetor to be so utterly shameless! All right, I was. But that's not what I'm trying to say here. What I'm trying to say is...
I know. No matter how selfish you are, life's empty without anyone to share it with.
Correct.
She's got a point.
More than anything, I don't want to give up. Not on myself. Pretty strange, isn't it?
It's amazing. It's not like I'm happy about it or anything.
If you're worried about Lafi or Celica, you don't need to be. I was just wondering what makes the moon turn so red.
They say the Crimson Moon is a gate to beyond, and is proof of humanity's sins.
A sign of sin, huh? Maybe the moon drinks up the innocent blood spilled by the wicked.
Take a wicked mind indeed to come up with something like that.
Please, don't say such frightening things.
A scarlet night occurs whenever a full moon is in a certain position. The land and the moon pull at each other, and Earth Pulse energy spills into the sky.
Yes, and the amount of power is said to create enough mana to affect even an Empyrean.
So that's why the ritual is done on a scarlet night.
But the world of humanity is violent. And the Earth Pulse is stained with all the blood spilled throughout history. So Rokuro's theory might have hit a little closer to the truth than expected.
Oh, a wild guess hits the mark.
Don't get used to it.
It sure does look grim, though.
Yeah.
A powerful Earth Pulse flowing inside it.
It looks like we can reach the core from there.
Thank you.
I still don't have no way to travel faster. Oh well. Last little bit of the game anyway.
Scout ship set.
I'm freezing, so cold, getting sleepy.
If you fall asleep, we're leaving you. Are we ready for this?
Form one!
Three troubles receive life blessings!
You'll be facing Shigure soon.
Yeah, not long now. I know this is a weird time to bring this up, Lafayette, but there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
All right, ask away.
I knew you'd say that. So, how was your bath and Mercio?
Huh?
You went in with Velvet, right?
Well, what are you getting at?
Let me in on this too. There's nothing to be ashamed of. There are just certain times in life when you need to find your resolve and seize the opportunity. We just want to know what your resolve got you.
Right. It's like a test.
Stop it! I didn't go into the back.
Well, that's a shame. That might have been your one shot. Once you're all grown up, you won't be able to get away with it.
That's why I didn't do it. I'm tired of Velvet treating me like a little kid.
Right. You don't need me to watch over you anymore.
Why did you laugh like that?
We're just happy that you're growing up.
I don't understand you two. If you're just gonna pick on me, go away.
We're sorry, but I really needed that. Laughter's good for the soul.
Rokuro, were you feeling tense?
You wouldn't think it, huh? But now I can fight like I always do. I owe you, Lafayette.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Oh, God. Like
next. Yeah.
Useless dialogue.
Rokuro, how do you think Sugure will move against us?
He's not really
a worth kill type.
He'll be out in the open, waiting for us.
Perfect place for a flanking attack.
We don't need to worry about an ambush. Shigure is waiting for us ahead.
Wow, really? He's really just waiting for us here? Rokuro!
It's okay.
Incredible! The old bastard forged himself into a sword!
Indeed. That blade's the embodiment of Kurogane's centuries of study.
The Kurogane Stormquell. I like it.
Just Kurogane for now. He will be the blade that surpasses both Stormquell and Stormhowl. And when it does, then he will have earned the name Kurogane Stormquell.
That mustache is fierce.
Ah, yeah. This is gonna be fun.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Watch out. I wouldn't be surprised if he used an Armatus.
An Armatus? It's not my style to rely on anyone's help.
Ha! Says the big bad exorcist. Look, you'll even ask a tubby kitty for help.
Shut up! I'm totally not!
He isn't. Quite the opposite, actually. Shigure asked me to restrain his power.
Restrain his power? Wait, you don't mean...
She does. It's for my training. At first, I could barely even move my little finger. Morgrem, release my bindings. Can a human
Raven even be this strong?
Kitty Wampus was holding him back?
With enough will, humans can do anything. This was to be my secret weapon against Artorias. I'm impressed.
Bokuro!
Sorry, but we're pitching in.
Good. I'll take you all at once.
Forget about fighting fair! You won't beat me unless you use everything you've got!
I know. All too well. All right. Let's have some fun. You got it. Round 1013, begin. Seriously? You're still counting? Only because they were all losses. But that ends today.
But I'm this close. I won't miss. Form zero. Double hit. It'll be the same every time! Tuckus style! Final judgment! You can handle my attacks now! This is where the fight truly begins, Shigure!
What do you know? I totally agree.
I wonder what would have happened if we didn't have him in the party.
Thank you.
Yes!
People are really something, aren't you? Don't act like you're impressed. I haven't even shown you my true blade. Your true blade? Well then, no time for me to take a break.
Shigure!
Keep out of this one, Morgrem.
He's still got plenty of power left.
Of course he does. He's Shigure Rangetsu, after all. Two blades, you sure? Why don't you find out? It's your life on the line. The same goes for you. So this is your true blade. That's right. I developed this technique to defeat you. Not bad at all. This is my parting gift to Kurogane. Take Storm Howl. One last thing. Please, let this fat cat go.
Shigure?
Shigure, you were ordered to be executed because I was already planning on leaving. I was sick of living the life of a chain dog. Stop worrying about the little things. Rejoice when your blade finds its mark. Seethe when it doesn't. Die when one finds you. That's all there is to it. The way of the sword is a simple one. That's what makes it so much fun.
Yeah. It really is.
That's the vicious face I'm looking for. If only Artorias's stony face could smile like that, he'd be a lot happier.
Yeah. Velvet.
We're good?
We're good. My blade found its mark.
You should get out of here while you still have the chance.
If things get hairy, I'll run. But please, let me stay here a little longer. I owe Shigure for giving me back my free will, and he always did hate to be alone.
I never knew that.
You didn't? Weren't you his brother?
We never had time to think about anything other than our training.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean any insult. He lived and he died according to his own beliefs. That has to be good enough. Humans like that are not so bad.
I suppose we aren't.
You're a funny sort of mob.
Thanks for the
If you want to leave now,
Rokuro, you said something to him at the end.
To Shigure?
Yeah. Maybe it's not my place to ask.
I don't mind. It was just something that happened long ago. The story about Shigure plotting to overthrow our lord. That was a lie. A lie that I spread.
But why?
I wanted a just cause to strike him down. Storm Howl, Shigure's name, the leadership of the clan. I used to want all of that for myself.
Do you regret it?
Not at all. Besides, Shigure figured it out a long time ago. But really, I don't know what made me think I had the strength to defeat him back then.
He was truly strong.
Of course he was. He was the head of the Rangetsu family, the strongest warriors in all the land.
Rokuro, does this make you head of the clan now?
No. I'm a demon. And more importantly, all I ever wanted was to beat my brother. That's enough for me.
Oh, we should go back. I can save just in case there's not a safe spot up there. Another thing, we better do this now.
Me in? Fine by me.
Whatever reason, I think those three would be. I mean, if he was in the party and, you know, he wasn't able to do, his brother wasn't able to do his mystic art, then maybe I need to keep people who can deflect the mystic arts or have some type of, like, connection to him. I know Maggie used to be a student, and I know Aizen wanted to beat him, but I'll keep this, switch those two out, because I think they may be able to stop whatever mystic art he may have. I mean, it's just a hunch, but I feel like I kind of got lucky on I got lucky on Rokuro being able to, um, inflicted mystic art by chance. I kind of got lucky on that. I didn't know it was going to do that.
No, it's torrid! Wait, no! It's hot!
Can you please stop making a fuss?
Anyone who can keep their cool inside a volcano needs their head examined!
I can feel the power of the Earth pulse flowing upward. This is the life spring.
That's odd. Melchior isn't here.
Have you devoured even Shigure, Lord of Calamity? But remember, the only exorcist whose souls are worthy of sacrifice are Shigure, Oscar, Teresa, and me!
He's above us, at the volcano's peak.
With three souls, you can only awaken three Empyreans! That won't be enough to seal Innominant's power! If you are missing even one, awakening them will cause this volcano to explode, with you inside it. If you seek to awaken all four elemental Empyreans, then come, try and take my soul from me!
What do you think, Mogulu?
Trap. Melchior's greatest strength lies in his power over ice. I only wish we could lure him down here.
But we dare not forget. He's an exorcist who spent years plotting to awaken Innominat.
Exactly. He could be capable of anything. It'd be dangerous to assume otherwise.
Maybe this is the wrong time, but Mogulu, you're related to Melchior, right?
You'd better believe it's the wrong time. Long ago, I was Mogulanika Loom Maven, Melchior's foster daughter, and before I was cast out, his disciple.
Mogulanika? The Lost Legate?
So even after 10 years, my name still lives on.
I'm impressed. You must have commanded a lot of respect.
Not in the least. The relationship between Melchior and I was like that between Velvet and Artorias. The debts owed, and the grudges held. Velvet, you don't have to believe me. You may never believe me. But I tell you now, I want to settle my...
I'm going to the peak to find him. Just doing what I want. Like always.
Yep, that's right. And I'm going with you. Like always.
Eye on this thing.
Thank you. We just need one last soul.
Are you all right?
I'll eat Melchior.
I'm not worried about that. You collapsed after the thing with Teresa and Oscar, remember?
You wonder if I'm fine after eating Shigure.
But wasn't Shigure a lot more powerful than they-
But look at me. I'm fine, right?
No.
I think I'm just used to it. Both my body and mind.
You're not just used to it.
Mm-hmm.
Just as I changed after finding my free
will- Oh god, are they really gonna do this?
Did I though?
You did!
I'll make you a quiche.
Could you make pudding too?
Sure. But are you just trying to butter me up so I'll cook for you?
Well, yeah. How did-
Oh, can we just- really Damn. Ronald?
All right.
Yeah!
Told you, man, I don't like useless dialogue. That do me useless.
Scout.
Gotta keep moving.
I'm not sure what Melchior is really capable.
To put it short, he's the Exorcist's shadow.
Their shadow?
They're supposed to be free of malevolence, but they're only human. And so are those who they want to save. But sincerity and conviction alone won't save the world. To remain free of malevolence, they need someone to do their dirty work. A shadow.
I see. And that's Melchior's job.
During all my time at the Abbey, I was never aware of what he was really doing.
So, why hasn't he succumbed to malevolence?
Because his belief in the Exorcists as the saviors of the world is pure and unyielding. It is a mountain of ice that will neither boil, nor melt, nor break. I know the depths of his frozen heart all too well.
Wait! Does that mean you?
Yes. Melchior was raising me to be the shadow for the next leader of the Exorcists. Artorias himself. But that was a terrible mistake. I was unable to live up to his expectations.
So if things had gone as he planned, we'd be fighting you instead of Melchior.
I'm glad that didn't have to happen.
True. If Mogulu was running the Abbey,
they would be completely unpredictable. That would be fearsome.
Maybe. But doesn't that sound like a whole lot of fun?
So Melchior was my shadow too.
Oh, feeling too sympathetic to fight him.
I wouldn't say that.
There's nothing to be sad about. Removing shadows is part of a shadow's job. Even if I'm a failed shadow, I'm still a witch, and I cast a deeper darkness.
Got a wrist of this. At least they got something out of it. That damn sure was what it was. my god, dude, come on!
I can't die here. Disgraceful.
Damn when he's bullshit like that. Why do you make them so fucking fast?
I can see the peak just ahead. If Melchior's anywhere, he's there.
Be careful. That crafty old buzzard is nothing like Shigure. He won't fight us head on.
The four elemental Empyreans are the beings that maintain the balance and harmony between earth, water, wind, and fire. Have you even stopped to think about why they sleep? About what waking them will do to this world's order?
Not really. I don't much care.
They sleep because of arrogant, insolent wretches like you. The Empyreans derive their power and that of their blessings from the prayers of the pure at heart. But humans became corrupted and neglected their prayers. The forgotten Empyreans drifted into slumber.
Human prayers are the source of their power? Just like the Malakim.
Are you trying to say Innominat blesses someone when he eats their soul?
As the fifth Empyrean, Innominat's purpose is to eat human souls, malevolence and all, and to wipe the slate clean. When all mankind is once again pure as a newborn babe, the elemental Empyreans can be safely revived.
You want to wipe the slate? But that means...
Yes, civilization will crumble. The spread of malevolence, the cleansing of the Innominat, the cycle has repeated countless times over the eons. That is why human civilization rises and falls. But if this continues, humanity will never surpass a certain threshold. Thus, the Abbey will control Illuminati's power, so that we may guide humanity into a new, better era.
It all makes sense now. You developed the art of armatization to control Illuminati.
And in order to create the Armatus, you needed the technology found in Siegfried, didn't you?
So that's why you got Eifried involved in all of this.
Just as light cannot exist without darkness, no great achievement comes without sacrifice. Even I must be made tribute for the sake of our ideal world!
Armatus!
No, you don't!
Aizen, stop!
I told you, he's a crafty old buzzard.
I should have known.
He looks different. Water and earth.
I'm Magilanica no longer! I am the evil witch, Magilu!
Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try! Perfect mayhem! Go!
Driven by the cold of cold, there you shall perish! Absolute freedom!
No, I can't.
Yes.
Dark despair.
That was stupid.
An oath to add years to his life, centuries even.
Is that what you call rational? Sounds like an obsession.
I've said the same thing thousands of times. If it were my choice, I'd have let myself die naturally long ago. But did he not say? Man can turn reason into disorder. But also, can we surpass it? Our true power is in transcending the possible to achieve the ideal.
So were the words of the exorcist Claudin.
They were foolish.
Think what you will. I'll show you the truth of his words.
Ah!
think illusions will work on us now?
Not in the least. But it bought me enough time to finish my art.
Are you trying to set off the volcano?
You'll die too!
As long as I take the Lord of Calamity with me, I have no regrets. That's because I follow reason!
Master, emotions are a real pain, aren't they?
And of course, there will be some space above the Earth.
What was that?
The elemental Empyreans have awoken.
We are free. We will no longer be your tools.
Oh dear, what's happening?
You saved us, Mogulu. Thanks. If you hadn't thrown Melchior off balance, we'd all be dead.
I settled my own affairs. Nothing more. But if you want to thank me, I accept gifts.
I take it back.
He couldn't hurt those flowers. Was that his oath?
No. That old fool loved flowers more than anything else. Far more than he did any living human. That's all there was to it.
I suppose even a legate can never fully control his heart.
Same goes for a witch. Sometimes living can be the hardest affliction.
Have the four elemental Empyreans awakened?
Who knows? But anything that would sleep through that isn't worth our time.
Better watch your mouth or they'll smite you. I can feel a shift in Enominat's domain.
Yeah. All four of them have awoken. Enominat has been pushed out from the Earth pulses.
Humanity's amplified resonances will diminish, and many Malakim will regain their free will. The Exorcists will likely lose a good chunk of their forces.
Eleanor, have you lost your ability to fight too?
Sorry to disappoint, but I can still see you. Evil demons, Malakim, and witches alike.
You know where he is.
I can feel him. His body has left the Earth pulses. He's somewhere above the Empyrean's throne now. Artorias is with him. However, Enominat is pushing back against the other Empyreans with incredible force.
If the four are defeated, we'll lose our last chance. No time to waste.
Let's go.
Yeah.
I'm here on orders from the boss to help you guys out.
We could certainly use it.
I came here from Helleviz, so I don't know how far the suppression has progressed. But I can tell you that the Abbeys designated the area north of Helleviz as a Class 4 administrative zone.
Which means they've pulled their forces out of the area.
What about the people of Mercio?
Everyone got out safe and sound, although they did petition for the extermination of the Lord of Calamity.
Of course.
I say we make this town our new hideout. When else are we ever gonna find a hideout that comes with hot springs?
That's a good idea. We should leave Kamoana and the others here.
Dial, could you stay and help them out?
As if you even had to ask.
Well, that's surprisingly reliable for you, Dial.
Hey, that hurts. Now get going already. Benwick and the crew are making preparations in Helleviz right now.
Right. I think I'm gonna do a little bit more. I just want to leave town and see.
Welcome back! I take it you defeated the Legates.
Yes, but that still leaves Enominat and the Shepherd.
Onward ho to the last battle! Oh, I picked up something nice for you. Here.
An apple?
It's a fortune apple. A good luck charm. No real powers, but they're hard to find. Legend has it, they're pretty lucky.
A fortune apple.
But we're the bad guys, aren't we? Maybe what we need is bad luck instead.
Aw, that's just mean.
Well, I appreciate the thought. Thanks, Benwick. I love apples.
Just don't eat it.
I couldn't eat it, even if I wanted. Wait a moment. That's right. My power to consume is a part of Enominat. If that's true, then...
What is it?
You want a bite? Delicious fortune apple.
No way! That's a good luck charm!
That it is. One to give you the courage you need to survive.
So, where's our final destination?
The Empyrean's throne.
Sail for Port Zexen. Aye, aye, ma'am.
So, I'm gonna take me a nice little break, give me some food, and when we come back, we're gonna finish this game. We're gonna finish it. We're gonna fucking finish it. Because right now, I need food.